Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. We are continuing our SEC football predictions today, and our next team lost their head coach but returned 17 starters and looked like a legitimate threat in the SEC West. They are the Mississippi State Bulldogs. Mississippi State had a roller coaster season last year. They upset number 12 LSU in just the third week of the season in dominating fashion, but then lost their next two games on the road to Auburn and Georgia, both in blowout fashion. Went on a bit of a winning streak, almost upset number 1 Alabama in Starkville, losing to the Crimson Tide in the final seconds, and then lost in the Egg Bowl to Ole Miss in dramatic fashion as well, losing their starting quarterback Nick Fitzgerald in that game, which put them at an 8-4 record to end the season. During the bowl season, Dan Mullen left to take the job at Florida, and then Mississippi State went into their bowl game and upset Louisville, shutting down Lamar Jackson, a game that I really did not see coming. But very impressive by them. They hired Joe Moorhead over in the offseason, the offensive coordinator from Penn State, and he inherits a team that has 17 returning starters, including 9 on offense and 8 on defense. So he inherits a very, very solid Mississippi State team that Dan Mullen was able to build up, and I expect them to have a very, very solid season in his first year at Starkville. So they open the season against Stephen F. Austin. Shouldn't be any problems there. Obviously, these games are always good to see where your team is and how they are looking going into some of their bigger games of the season. And, of course, the biggest thing for Mississippi State is going to be, can Nick Fitzgerald stay healthy? He had a pretty gruesome injury in that Egg Bowl loss to cap off the season. So if he can come back at full health like he was for the majority of last season, they will be a legitimate threat in the SEC West. And then a very intriguing matchup to kick off week 2 on the road at Kansas State. Now, we know you should never doubt a Bill Snyder team. He's done a great job during his career with the Wildcats. They returned 8 starters on the offensive side of the ball. And I can see this game really turning into a shootout, a fairly high-scoring game. Mississippi State, as I mentioned before, has a very solid defensive line led by Montez Sweat. If you take a look, there are 4 defensive line starters. None of them are underclassmen. 3 seniors and 1 junior. So very deep, very talented defensive line. That one that's not really getting a lot of attention but could give a lot of teams some fits. And then both of the court, Mississippi State and Kansas State both have some very exciting offenses. Kansas State led by Alex Delton. And then Mississippi State has plenty of options on the offensive side of the ball. You have Nick Fitzgerald at quarterback, Aris Williams at running back, Keith Mixon at wide receiver, Jesse Jackson, all of those guys on the offensive side of the ball. So this game being at Kansas State, certainly not an easy place to play, but I'm going to give the edge to Mississippi State solely based on their defense. I think this could be a very offensive game, a lot of points being scored, but it's going to come down to who can get a stop towards the end. Mississippi State has the better defense. I'm going to give them a big win on the road against a talented Kansas State team. And then, of course, another win here against Louisiana, a Sun Belt team, a little bit of a tune-up before they start SEC play on the road against Kentucky. Now, Kentucky, another team in the SEC East that could surprise a couple people, should be able to get back to a bowl game. Mark Stoops doing a good job there, getting them to back-to-back bowl games. I would be very, very tempted to pick Kentucky here if they had not lost their quarterback in Stephen Johnson. I thought he played fairly well last season. Was a very good dual threat quarterback, was getting better. They still have their running back in Benny Snell. And with his being on the road, I've seen over recent years as Mark Stoops has developed his Kentucky program, they've definitely gotten a little bit better at home and upset a couple solid teams there, or nearly upset a couple solid teams. But without a solid quarterback, this could be a very big defensive battle because Kentucky's strength is going to be their defense. But once again, I'm going to give the edge to Mississippi State here, solely based on their offense. So like I said, I'm giving them the edge against Kansas State on the road due to their defense. I'm going to give them the edge here at Kentucky based on their offense because I think that's going to be Kentucky's weakness. And especially going up against a deep and talented Mississippi State defense, I don't think their offense is going to get much going. And then Florida, big game for a number of reasons. The biggest one, obviously, Dan Mullen leaving Mississippi State to go and take the Florida job. So that's going to be huge. His first return to Starkville, not as head coach of the Bulldogs. That's going to be very, very exciting. And he also inherited a very talented Florida team with 19 returning starters, 10 on offense, 9 on defense. A lot of people are questioning who the Florida quarterback is going to be. General consensus looking like Felipe Franks, but we're not really sure yet. But this is going to be very, very fun to watch, just the whole environment, knowing that Dan Mullen's coming back here. I expect this game to have plenty of offensive fireworks in it. Could be very, very high scoring. In the end, though, I know Mississippi State's going to be fired up. The crowd's going to be fired up. If this game had been in the swamp, I would be picking Florida. But I'm going to give the win to Mississippi State, getting a big win against their former head coach. And then Auburn coming in right before their bye week, back-to-back big SEC games for the Bulldogs. And this is a game that could really determine who finishes second in the SEC West. Of course, many people, including myself, are picking Alabama to finish first in the West. But this game will definitely determine who will finish second. I don't see anybody else below these guys making a push for that spot. Auburn, a very talented team, led by Gus Malzahn, Jarrett Stidham at quarterback. So another fun quarterback battle here between Nick Fitzgerald and Jarrett Stidham. So I'm very excited to see that. I said in my Auburn video that I'm going to base this solely on experience. And a team with the most experience is going to be Auburn in this game. It's going to be close. And I was very, very tempted to pick Mississippi State in this game. But in the end, I'm going to give the edge to Jarrett Stidham and his offense going on the road here and getting a big-time win in Starkville. Another bye week for Mississippi State going into their road game at LSU. And if you remember last year, I picked Mississippi State to upset LSU, and a lot of people called me crazy on that. They said there was no way that even though it was in Starkville, that Mississippi State was going to beat LSU. They won that game 37-7. So a very, very solid outing for the Bulldogs against a Tigers team that had a solid season going 9-3 in the regular season, but obviously not meeting the expectations they wanted. This year, I think expectations are much lower for the Tigers. They don't have a super solid team this year. Sure, they bring in Joe Burrow at quarterback. That's what a lot of people are talking about. The defense will certainly be their strength, but only 10 returning starters. Can Mississippi State come into Death Valley and get a win on the road, a big win, especially coming off a loss against Auburn and having a bye week to prepare for it? I'm picking LSU in this case to pull off the upset against Mississippi State. You usually don't hear that word very often, LSU pulling the upset against Mississippi State. Usually be the other way around. But I think LSU, with a poor year this year, is going to get a big win at home, a much-needed win at home, over the Mississippi State Bulldogs, handing them their second straight loss. And once again, I'm going to base that solely off of home field advantage and defense as well. And then they get Texas A&M at home, back-to-back home games here against Texas A&M and Louisiana Tech. And as we've mentioned, Texas A&M bringing in Jimbo Fisher does not necessarily mean guaranteed success right off the bat. It took him a little bit to get things going at Florida State, and he doesn't inherit a super solid team at A&M. Of course, he brings in 16 returning starters, but it doesn't necessarily mean great success. So this is going to be a very intriguing game here, but I think Mississippi State handles this fairly well. They went on the road and got a solid win against A&M last year. I think they get another big win here at home against the Aggies. It shouldn't be much of a problem for Nick Fitzgerald and this offensive crew. Then another win here against Louisiana Tech. Of course, they played the Bulldogs on the road last year. Got a very big blowout win there. Shouldn't be much of a problem for them. A good tune-up going into the Alabama game on the road at Bryant-Denny Stadium. Now, I said in my Alabama video that with it being at home, that's a major factor. And I think this Alabama defense could rattle that Mississippi State offense, getting into Nick Fitzgerald's head a little bit. Remember, last time they were here, it was a 51-3 victory for the Crimson Tide. And I said I do not think that it will be that big of a blowout again this year. I think this game will actually be very close. I think this game could be super close going into the fourth quarter, and then the Crimson Tide start to pull away a little bit. Get a late turnover, a late stop, something like that. I think Tua Tagovailoa that late into the season is going to be on a roll. Alabama should be undefeated at this point. I do not see Mississippi State coming in and winning on the road at Alabama, but it will be closer than many expect. So a loss here for Mississippi State, giving them 3 on the year. Then they get a home game against Arkansas. These teams have had some classic matchups over the year. Same with Mississippi State and LSU. Last year, Mississippi State going into Arkansas and narrowly escaping with a victory. I believe it was 28-21. This year, having it at home, though, with an Arkansas team that has a lot of questions surrounding them. Chad Morris, who's going to be the quarterback? Is the defense going to improve any from a team that was just horrendous last year? This should not be a huge issue for Mississippi State. I do not see Arkansas's defense able to contain that very explosive and talented Mississippi State offense. And then on the other hand, Mississippi State's very experienced defensive line should be able to break through the Arkansas offensive line that should struggle a lot this year. Shouldn't be much of a problem for the Bulldogs. They get a win over the Razorbacks at home. And then, of course, Thanksgiving night, they only have 5 days to prepare at Ole Miss in the Egg Bowl. Of course, one of the more classic games in all of college football. It's going to be a lot of fun to watch. This is a revenge game for the Bulldogs after narrowly losing last year, 31-28. Of course, losing Nick Fitzgerald in that game. With him being a senior, I know he's not going to want to go out with a loss in his final Egg Bowl, assuming he can stay healthy. This was a game that I struggled with as well because it is at Ole Miss, and Ole Miss is not a team people need to sleep on. They have a very talented quarterback as well in Jordan Te'amu and a very, very good wide receiver core that is going to really test the defensive backs for Mississippi State. So it is on the road. They do have a very solid team, But I'm going to give the edge to the Mississippi State Bulldogs here to get another win in SEC play, which will give them 9-3 record for the season in Joe Moorhead's first season. Now, I'm basing that on this game, mostly on experience of the Mississippi State offense as well, and Ole Miss's defense is not going to be that strong. So with a poor defense going up against that tough of an offense, Mississippi State should be able to exploit that defense enough to put up enough points, even if Ole Miss can do the same to Mississippi State's defense, to get a win on the road in the Egg Bowl. And 9-3 is extremely, extremely respectable for Joe Moorhead in his first year in Starkville. That would be a very good season for them. Maybe they could pull off an upset against Auburn and get to double-digit wins, crack 10 wins. And that would put them at second in the SEC West. And all they would need is maybe one other upset here against whether maybe LSU or potentially Alabama to really compete for an SEC West crown. So Mississippi State is going to be a very talented team this year. Do not sleep on them. As you may have heard, we do have a Twitter account now, at Gridiron Expert. At Gridiron Expert. So make sure you go check us out there. And as always, please continue to like, comment, and subscribe. And we will see you next time on the Gridiron Expert.